Добре, здравейте отново от мен. Радвам се да видя, че още хора се присъединяват към тази презентация. Това е Американският университет в Рим Джон Кабот, един от популярните американски университети в Италия. Аз ще оставя Джесика да си направи своята презентация, като ще изчакам още една минута, за да може хората, които са участвали на предходната презентация, също да се включат. И отново да подсета тук, моля, задавайте своите въпроси в чат бокса, за да може след това да ги получим като записани и ако не успеем да отговорим на някой от тях, да върнем информацията в имейл комуникацията, която ще последва след събитието. Отново, благодаря ви, че участвате в нашето събитие. Well, Jessica, you can start your presentation.
Wonderful. Thank you so very much for the introduction. I appreciate it. Hello, everyone, and welcome to today's session with John Cabot University, Transformative Global and Personal. My name is Jessica Silva, and I am the International Admission Counselor with John Cabot University. And I work with students across the world who are looking to apply or learn more about our university and our community. So if you do have any questions after this presentation, I would encourage all of you to get in touch with me via email. We can also set up a one-on-one Zoom session just so that you get all the information that you would need for our university. So just to get started, who was John Cabot anyways? So John Cabot University was founded in 1972, and we were named after Giovanni Caboto, or John Cabot, as he was later called, as he was sailing under the English flag in the 15th century. So John Cabot was an Italian navigator and explorer working and sailing across the seas over to the Americas and really opening the channels for further exploration. So it's quite fitting that we are named after Giovanni Caboto or John Cabot. So John Cabot University is a small American liberal arts institution, and we are about 1,400 students, but very diverse, with over 70 different nationalities represented in that student population. We do have an average class size of 15 students and a 15-to-1 student to faculty ratio. So lots of wonderful time, one-on-one time with your professors and your classmates. So you're going to be in nice small class settings, which is really great for discussions and really fostering that American liberal arts curriculum that we have at JCU. Please keep in mind that all of our courses at John Cabot will be taught in English, so you don't have to worry about knowing Italian if you are coming to JCU. I personally highly encourage students to either take a class or two in Italian. It's not a required component for your education, but it's always nice to help your acclimation in the local community, of course, in Rome. So why would you want to come to Rome anyways? Of course, it is a major European capital. It is home to embassies, international organizations, and multinational companies. So whatever it is that you decide you want to study at John Cabot, good chances that you'll be able to take whatever it is that you're studying and go out into the city and really explore that a bit further. Whether you're studying business or if you're studying art history, Rome is going to be an amazing city to really explore after your time in your classes. We really are in a living museum. We are in the city center of Rome, and there are over 50 museums in the city, over 900 churches, and 12 UNESCO heritage sites. So students really have the opportunity to learn more, you know, as they're exploring the city, going to galleries, going to museums. And of course, some of that is coupled with our professors taking students out into what we call the living laboratory of the city of Rome. Our central location is a perfect place to explore other parts of Europe. So it's really nice that we do see students, you know, doing some independent travel. I think that's pretty highly encouraged across campus because we do understand that students who are traveling are also enriching their own academics and what they bring back to the campus community. And then, of course, we are going to be immersed in Italian language and culture if you are joining us at JCU. So, you know, whether you're on campus or off campus, you will be hearing Italian, you will be immersed in the Italian culture, which is really quite exciting. So for our facilities, we have a map here that I want to show you. So we are located, as I mentioned, in the city center of Rome, and we are located in a neighborhood called Trastevere. And that is going to be right along the Tiber River, and the Tiber River runs through the city center of Rome. As you can see here through the various dots that we have on this map, those are some of our facilities across campus. You'll notice that our campus isn't a centralized location. We're not gated, so you don't have, you know, campus in one kind of block area with gates around. It's really going to be spread out through the Trastevere neighborhood. So on the far right here, you will find our Fratelli campus. This is going to house our admission office. On the far left here, you're going to find our Guarini campus and some of our other buildings, including residence halls, sprinkled in between there. All of our buildings at JCU are very multi-purpose, so students will find different things in those buildings, from dining halls to our faculty offices, to our classroom spaces. You'll also find things, common spaces such as patios and computer labs and libraries that you can access. From one end of the campus to the other, it's probably around 10 to 15 minute walk, so not too far at all. When you're walking from one building to the other, as I mentioned, you're going to be right in the heart of that neighborhood, so you will be walking by bars and restaurants, cafes. So it's really lovely. If you don't want to maybe go to the dining hall that day, you can grab a quick lunch at a nearby restaurant. So it's a really wonderful area to be in Trastevere. Now, in terms of our academics at JCU, as I mentioned, we are an American liberal arts institution, and we're also highly focused in areas of humanities and social sciences when it comes to our academics. So we offer 14 different majors, 19 different minors, and you have flexibility to choose any of our majors that we offer once you're admitted to the institution. So we'll talk a little bit more about the application process a little bit later in this presentation, but basically when you apply, you're applying to the whole institution. You do not have to apply to a specific major with JCU. Once you're admitted, you can choose, you know, that you, if you wanted to say study communications and maybe do a double major with international affairs, that's a possibility. Or maybe you come in thinking that you would love to study communications, but then maybe after a year you decide, oh, maybe that's not the best fit for me, and they actually want to study business. So it's really up to you what you would like to study. Typically, we encourage students to select a major no later than their sophomore year, just because after that, you may run into some issues with completing your degree within the 4 years. So that's just something to keep in mind. We do offer, as I mentioned, 19 different minors, and those minors are going to be all of the majors that we have, with exception to international business. So we do not have an international business minor. But in addition, we do have art and design, creative writing, entrepreneurship, legal studies, mathematics, and philosophy as well. At JCU, our more popular majors are going to include business administration, international business, communications, and art history. So those are really kind of the top majors that students choose. But again, you have flexibility to choose any of our majors. The great thing about being in a smaller community such as JCU is that you don't have to deal with impacted majors that you may come across other larger institutions. That means that if you are interested in studying business, but maybe you're at a larger institution, there aren't any classes available for you to join to be able to complete those major requirements. At JCU, because we are quite small and we have that 15-to-1 student to faculty ratio, you can actually go ahead and take those classes without having to push back your graduation time, which is quite nice. Now, most of our students who are joining us at JCU are actually coming from abroad, so students coming outside of Italy. If you are interested in studying abroad, You know, during your time with us, that is absolutely something that you can do. We do have partnerships with over 30 different institutions across the world. So whether you want to go to another part of Europe, if you want to go to Asia, or maybe the Americas, that's an opportunity that you can take while you're a student with us at JCU. The great thing about this opportunity is that you pay the same John Cabot tuition even if you are abroad. So if you decide you want to go to the United States, you would still be paying that same tuition that you would if you were staying in Italy with us at JCU, which is quite nice. Now, in terms of campus life, this is something I really stress to students. This is going to be a big part of your campus experience because we are quite small. We really do want to encourage students to foster a strong knit community. And you'll find that in a few different areas in our campus. First, starting with housing. So we do offer housing for students. We have four main options to choose from. The first is going to be our on-campus housing, and those are going to include our Gian Nicolo residence and our Lungara apartments. So students can be on campus, on that campus map that I showed you, those are going to be some of our housing options. So really quite accessible to any of your classes that you can just get up, you know, get ready and head to class and be in class within 5-minute walk, which is really quite nice. I really encourage this option for our first year students. I think it's important to be able to come in and get acclimated to your community, get to know your other classmates, as well as your professors, and really get comfortable with the campus before maybe venturing off and potentially getting your own apartment. The next option is going to be our Trastevere apartment. So these are apartments that are still run by JCU, but they're really more independent. But you still get some of the great aspects of being on campus, such as 24-hour security at these apartments. You still have great cleaning service that comes in, but it's still considered a little bit further from campus. And then lastly is going to be independent apartments. So that's really you going off and finding your own apartment that you would like to stay in. Typically, as I mentioned, this is going to be for our older students. Once you've already made some friends, potentially you want to rent an apartment together and to have a little bit more of that independence. The great thing about being in Rome is that we have great public transportation. So you don't have to worry about not being able to get to campus, even if you are living a little bit further away from the Trastevere neighborhood. Also, another part of housing, it's not just, of course, somewhere where you sleep. It's also a place where you interact with other classmates. So with our housing that's on campus, we have some common spaces available for students, whether that's patios or living rooms, where you can have some time to form some study groups, or maybe if you like to cook, we do have kitchens in our apartments. So it's really great to be able to hang out with other classmates and do some cooking as well. So that's something to keep in mind there. Now, I know not all students like to cook and maybe don't know how to cook quite yet. So we do have our Tiber Cafe that's located on campus. This is going to be our one and only dining hall at JCU, but it is quite equipped, so you won't need much more than this. This is going to be in our Tiber campus, also called our Tiber Cafe. Here you'll find a variety of meal plans available for students. So just depending on how much you like to cook or how many meals you need, you can adjust your meal plan accordingly. But here you'll find a full espresso bar available all day long. So whether you're needing to get an espresso shot, cappuccino, maybe a quick bread before class, you can do that there. We also have some cold options. So if you are looking for like a sandwich or a quick bite to eat, a quick salad, you can grab one of those items and head to class. Or if you are looking for a full kind of hot meal on campus, this is also going to be a great place to do so. So you can grab a plate, sit down and hang out with friends, do some studying right there in the cafeteria space, which is quite nice. Now, I do encourage students to go out there, get involved. Most of JCU students are involved with at least 2 to 3 clubs and organizations each semester that they're with us. We do offer over 30 for students each year. So it's really great that these are our student-led clubs. So sometimes you'll see some clubs kind of fade away, but then you'll also see some other clubs you know, that are started with our students. So it's really nice to see that students are so involved in these organizations. I would say for more popular clubs on campus, those are going to include our business club, of course, our Model United Nations, our Art History Society, and investment club. So like I said, business is quite a popular major at JCU. So you'll see some of our student activities surrounding that as well. And then we also have opportunities for students to go out and explore different parts of Italy or different parts of Rome through our cultural programs and trips and activities, which is really great. So these are events that students can join every single semester and you can sign up. The great thing about these opportunities is that students are going with staff from JCU. So no matter what activity you choose, you're going with a much more local perspective than you are with a tourist perspective. So whether that means you're going to do cooking classes or tours of local neighborhoods or potentially even a short weekend trip, this is a great way to get involved with other classmates on campus. Sometimes it can seem a little bit of a touristy kind of, class description, like mozzarella making trip, but honestly, it is really such a great opportunity to learn more about the Italian food and culture. And like I said, with our staff members, you're getting much more of that local perspective with these activities. There is a small fee associated for these activities on campus, but they typically sell out really quick because we do make them affordable for students and a great way for you to explore more. Other way to stay active on campus, of course, is through our athletics. We do have a few varsity teams, which include our soccer, basketball, volleyball, and cheerleading. And then we also have some other ways to stay active. For our varsity teams, you will be competing with other regional teams in the area, including other schools in Rome, which is nice. But if you are looking to stay active, but maybe not quite as much as maybe joining a varsity team, we do have intramural teams available for students to join. And then we also have some additional fitness classes that you can join. So that could be something like high intensity interval training, kickboxing, or yoga that you can participate in on campus. Now, in terms of our professional opportunities, I would say that John Cabot University is really career oriented. We want to make sure that students have a good grasp of having some experience, whether that's in an internship or a job opportunity prior to their graduation. So no matter what it is that you decide to do after your time at JCU, you feel like you've had some preparation for that time. So we do offer over 900 internship and job opportunities to students every single year. So chances are, if you are looking for something, you will be able to get placed with an opportunity. We have over 670 collaborating companies and organizations that come and do a career fair with us on campus, which is quite neat. So you actually get to, you know, still be on campus. You have companies come and speak to students face-to-face. Right now they're happening virtually, but we're hoping soon that we can bring those back in person. But this is a great opportunity to maybe chat with a company that you've been interested in working with. And sometimes they do have on-the-spot interviews for our students so that they can potentially do an internship or a job over the summer with one of these companies. We also offer a few different workshops through our Office of Career Services. Those are going to include things like resume building, mock interviews, so that you're really feeling prepared for any of those opportunities that may come your way. Now, we do have quite a few students who have gone around the world to do some internships during the summer. You will find, of course, some of our more established companies that we're all familiar with, including IBM, UNICEF, Coca-Cola, Deloitte, Hilton. But then you'll also have a good group of students who are interested in entrepreneurship and they would like to get placed with startup companies. In that case, students are really learning what it's like to grow a company from the ground up. And so it's really quite a beneficial experience for those students to maybe work with a startup company versus maybe working with a very established company. So just depending on your own interests, you can choose what you would like to get involved with. Now, let's change gears a little bit here and talk about the admission process and really what it means to join JCU, what that's going to look like in terms of applying. So we are on the Common Application. I'm sure many of you are familiar with the Common Application. It serves many institutions across the world. And we also have a direct application on our website. So if you are interested or already applying to other Common Application schools, it makes it nice and easy for you to apply to JCU as well. But if not, you can apply directly on our website. We do not have a preference on which application you choose. We just ask that you don't apply to both. After you submit your application, we are going to require official high school transcripts. And then we are going to request two letters of recommendation. Typically, these are coming either from your counselor or from your teachers in high school. It gives us another perspective on your application and your academics as well. We do ask for a 600-word personal essay. We do provide prompts for students, but really we're looking to see if you are a strong fit for our school academically as well as for the community. And then once you've submitted that application, we will be contacting you for an admission interview. Typically, this happens over the phone or via Zoom. And if you would be applying, you would actually be interviewing with myself. So it's kind of nice to know who that person would be. So it's quite informational. I just want to get to know you as a student a little bit more and maybe learn some things that I'm not able to get from your application alone. If you are currently taking high school in a language that is not English for at least 2 years, then we do require an English proficiency exam. And we do have some flexibility with that in terms of which exams you can submit. Those can be either the IELTS, Duolingo, or the TOEFL for those exams that you are submitting. Now, with all of these different components of the application, we are very holistic in the way that we review applications. So like I mentioned, we are looking at every single component that you submit. It's not just based on academics, but of course we will be looking at that. We're going to be looking at that writing, those letters of recommendation. And I also want to mention that we are test optional currently because of COVID-19. So with that, you do not have to submit any testing, ACT or SAT, and we'll probably continue that way moving forward, but it's not set in stone just yet. So yes, this is kind of what you need in terms of the application process. In terms of different curriculums, if you are completing an IB curriculum, you just need to make, if you're completing a full diploma, then we need at least a 24 on that diploma. And if you're not completing the diploma, that's okay as well. We don't require any kind of IB specific requirements for students to apply. If you are taking those exams and getting a four above on those classes, you may be eligible to receive some academic credit at JCU, which is great if you are maybe wanting to graduate a little bit earlier from the institution. Now, in terms of financial aid, we do offer two main forms for students. One is going to be merit-based and the other one is going to be need-based. For your merit-based scholarships, this is going to be based on that application that you send in. So they will be looking at your academics, and you can receive some grants, some scholarships from JCU. We also offer need-based aid. So you would be filling out an application with your family to submit for need-based financial aid, and we will be looking at your family income to determine your family need. So those are two separate avenues that you can choose. You do have to apply for financial aid at JCU. You're not automatically considered when you apply. So once you submit your full application for admission, I would then encourage you to go into our financial aid website and apply for that financial aid. We do have various amounts and it's going to vary per student. So I'm not going to give you, an average amount of aid that's given to students because we have scholarships that range up until a full ride with JCU. So it really just depends. I encourage all students to apply. It's great to just kind of know what your options are. Once you receive your financial aid package, if you have any questions, Our financial aid office is more than happy to kind of sit down with you and go over your package so you really know if this is going to be a good financial decision for you and your family. Over 85% of our students receive some kind of aid from JCU. So like I said, quite a few options to choose from. Now, in terms of what students are doing after their time at John Cabot, students are either going directly into graduate programs or potentially going directly into industry. For our graduate program, students are going all over the world to study different things. And you know, they've gone off to some really wonderful institutions, including Cambridge, Johns Hopkins, Oxford. And for students who are going into industry right after their time at JCU, we have a really high employment rate, 90% for students who are looking for a job, you know, right after they graduate. So just some flexibility there with all of that preparation that we do with our career services office. Students really feel prepared whatever path they choose to do, whether it's going to get more schooling or going into a job industry. Now, I want to take a moment to address COVID-19 and what that looks like at JCU currently. So we are fully open on campus. We are having in-person classes available for students. We still are, you know, enforcing social distancing in classroom spaces. We do require masks to be worn anytime you're on campus or an academic building. And we also have thermo scanning at each of our entryways. So when you kind of walk into a building, you get a quick temperature scan. And we do require that students are either fully vaccinated or showing a proof of a negative COVID test every 48 hours. So we do highly encourage students to be vaccinated if they are thinking about joining us at JCU. It makes it a little bit easier to not have to worry about getting that negative COVID test, you know, while you're with us. So that is my brief overview of John Cabot University. There is a nifty little QR code here. So if you want to put down more information, you can do that as well. You have my contact information. I did see that a few questions came in through the chat box. So if you do have additional questions that I did not address during this presentation, please feel free to use that chat box, and I will be taking some time now to answer those for students. So I did have a question come in. If you are studying communications, can I get the dual degree with University of Milan? No, so if you are studying communications, you know, with John Cabot University, you will be earning a John Cabot degree. So that really is going to be, you know, an American degree. So we don't have the accreditation through Italy. You are going to be earning an American four-year, you know, liberal arts, bachelor of arts degree. So just keeping that in mind.
Hi, Jessica. Just to say that I'm here to help you if you need some help with reading the questions, answering, etc.
Perfect. Thank you so much. I think so far all the questions are in English. Let's see what's the next question.
It's serious question, I would say.
I'm just kind of taking a look at that. I would like to ask if there's an American university, can we apply for professional opportunities there? I'm hoping I get this question right. Are you referring to opportunities in the United States or opportunities in Italy?
I think she refers to opportunities in John Cabot, in Rome, because the ending of the question is, holder of an MA from a Fulbright scholarship as well. Can I apply for a visitor professor position?
Yes. Okay. So that is a great question. I'm not sure I have the answer for that particular question because obviously this is something that doesn't come up quite often. I would encourage you to send me an email. I know typically we have students who can come and observe classes, things like that. But in terms of a visiting professor position, I'm not sure. That's something that I would have to get some additional information. So please feel free to email me. I believe my contact information is going to be shared with everyone attending. So I would encourage you to do that, and I can potentially get some additional information for you. Another question is, can we apply for a Cambridge certificate or only IELTS and TOEFL? You can use your Cambridge certificate if you would like, instead of the IELTS or TOEFL. I don't have the number because typically we're only looking at TOEFL, IELTS, or the Duolingo, and on what exactly would be the score that you need for that Cambridge certificate. So again, if you want to follow up with me after the presentation, I can get that particular score for you.
By the way, I posted a link to the English language requirements, and Cambridge, the minimum score for undergraduate admission is the Cambridge Advanced, 180 is the minimum.
Thank you so much for taking a look at that on our site. Thank you.
Direct entry. If you have less, you could choose the preparation program, which are two kinds, depending on the result. Yes.
Right. So those are going to be our endless programs. So if, for instance, you are interested in joining us at JCU, but maybe your English language is not quite at the scores that we need them to be, you can participate in our endless program. It's just going to be a bridging program where you're going to be studying English intensively before joining the degree program. So you can either do that for a semester or two semesters, and we also have funding for that as well. So you can apply for financial aid if you don't have those scores. That shouldn't mean that it should discourage you from applying to JCU. It just means you may need to add an additional semester or two if you are interested in bumping up that score a bit.
Okay.
In terms of fees, tuition and fees, we do, it's going to vary for students depending on housing, but typically for the bulk of your fees, it's going to be around 19,000 euro per academic year. And then with housing, like I said, that can really range typically between 3,600 euro to just over 7,000 euro added on top of that for housing alone. So just keeping that in mind.
Okay, I want to mention that I also sent the link for the tuition fees for European Union citizens.
Perfect.
And I want to add that there are some scholarships, merit and financial need, that during the application, you can understand, if you are granted a scholarship, and then the reduction of your tuition fee, which is valid actually for the 4 years of education. I wanted just to add.
Yes, and the great thing about JCU is that when you apply and if you are admitted and you decide you would like to come, your tuition fees will be the same for your 4 years. So you don't have to worry about tuition fees going up every single year. You're basically grandfathered into each year that you're there. So for the full 4 years, if you are getting those merit scholarships, those will stay with you and your tuition fees will not go up during that time. In terms of AP exams, if you are scoring a 4 or above on your AP exams, you are eligible for academic credit. I don't know if we have an AP list per se available on our website in terms of which classes would give you that credit, but typically what students would do when they're applying is also send us a official copy of their AP scores, and our office of our registrar would take a look at those and determine which classes would be eligible for credit. Typically this is happening after you've come to campus or just when you're starting off for your first semester. You would be sending those in, sitting down with an academic advisor to then discuss what AP courses can grant you credit at JCU.
I just want to add, because I think Kusara is more interested about the entry requirements. For example, if she wants to study business or international relations, or do they require to have a specific AP exams? No. Yes.
No. So like I mentioned it towards the beginning, regardless of your academic interest, whether it's business, art history, communications, the entry requirements are going to be exactly the same for every student who applies. So we don't require specific testing or AP courses or specific curriculum to have been completed prior to your time applying for JCU. Typically what we're looking for in different curriculums that students are applying with, because they can vary from country to country. So we want to make sure you're graduating from high school. So, you know, most students either fall into kind of the US system, you know, the English system, whether you're going to be doing your A levels or you're going to be doing IB. But typically that's kind of what we're looking for across the board, is that you're graduating from your high school curriculum with a diploma, and we'll be taking a closer look at your classes, your grades, what you've done. And that's why we also will look at other aspects of your application, such as your essay and your letters of recommendation, to determine your eligibility.
Yeah, and the last part of the question of Cossaro was about the living costs in Rome.
Right. So that's why I said the housing, those can really range, like I said, between 3,600 and about 7,000 euro per year that you're going to be, per semester that you'll be living either on campus. That's kind of the price range that I have for on campus. Of course, when you live off campus, things might, you know, be a bit more affordable, but those are going to range just depending on the market and what that looks like in Rome. But I would say traditionally, cost of living in terms of housing is going to be less expensive if you're living off campus versus living on campus. And but like I said, you know, living on campus for your first, you know, semester, first year is quite beneficial for students. So it really gives you an opportunity to get acclimated and know the community a bit more before venturing off and finding your own housing. That's not to say that you can't do that. You absolutely can, you know, as a first year student, but, you have that flexibility.
I know that you usually recommend take the housing opportunity for the first semester because it's by semester. And then you could search afterwards when you are settled, when you have more information, resources available on site.
Right. Should we accept the NACAC gross admission application fee waiver? In terms of a fee waiver, if you are looking for a fee waiver, we have our own fee waiver that we will grant to students. So, you know, for whatever, by, you know, whatever means, if a student is looking to apply, would love to apply for financial aid, and you would like a fee waiver, we are more than happy to grant that to you. Like I said, you can reach out to me via email, and I can make sure that you get that fee waiver to apply. Typically, it's about 50 euro to submit that application for JCU. In terms of self-reported scores, because we are not requiring the SAT for the admission process, if you still want to submit those to us self-reported, that's absolutely fine. Like I said, we'll look at them, but it's not a required component of the application. For the IELTS or for any of your language exams, we do require an official copy to be sent for your application. So we do need an official for IELTS, Duolingo, or TOEFL.
Okay, I think there are no more questions. At least I don't see any new.
Yeah, I don't as well.
Maybe you'd like to...
I'm gonna type in my email just in case.
Yes, perfect.
So if you do have any questions, or you're just kind of tracking that contact information down, it's just my first name, last name at johncabot.edu. So please feel free. Like I said, I would be the counselor working with all of you if you are interested in joining at JCU. So we can always schedule an additional follow-up meeting, or we can chat, you know, via email. So I would be happy to answer any additional questions, but it was a real pleasure, you know, getting to chat with you today, and hopefully we see some of you in Rome. No, the email is going to be jessica.silva@johncabot.edu.
We'll also make sure to put it in the follow-up email that you are going to send.
I see, because I put it over to hosts and panelists.
Oh, yes.
Yes, there. Now everyone should be able to see it. Yes. My mistake. I just thought it was for our hosts and panelists. So you should be able to see my email there now, jessica.silva@johncabot.edu.
Okay, thank you.
Perfect.
Thank you all. Jessica, would you like to add something? Maybe something?
No, I think that's it on my end. Like I said, any other questions come up, we'll be happy to chat. If you need any more information about any academic programs, or you would like to connect with a current student, we are able to do that as well. So it's always nice to be able to chat with the students, see what their experience is like. So if you email me, we can set that up for you as well.
Okay, so shall we wait a little bit more, or we can end the presentation?
Yeah, I mean, it's up to you. If any other questions come up, please feel free. If not, I think we're all set.
Just, I would like to remind to the guys who are just watching now that the next presentation is of WIS Guido Carli University, but you have 20 minutes until that presentation, so you can use them now, asking questions to Jessica or sending her an email afterwards. Yeah, I see the guys are thanking you, Jessica.
Yes, thank you so much. I hope you got some good information and help you determine if JC was a good fit. I appreciate it.
I have one question. So you do accept Duolingo this year, yes? The next year.
Great. Correct. We accept Duolingo, yes.
Great. Okay. Okay, thank you guys too. So, okay, Jessica, it's up to you to decide whether to finish.
Yeah, I think we'll go ahead and call it here and have a wonderful rest of your weekend, everyone. And I look forward to connecting some more. So I'm gonna go ahead and stop sharing my screen and appreciate your time.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Jessica. Bye-bye.